My name is Pastor Marlon Curtin. This is the Rockaway Cathedral. Welcome to our Sunday service. Welcome to our Sunday service. If you like what you see here, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Our foundational scripture is Matthew 7, verses 24 and 25. Matthew 7, verses 24 and 25. We at the Rockaway Cathedral say, we're building God's kingdom in you. Be blessed.
It's August 20th, 2023. Welcome to online worship at the Rockaway Cathedral. We are so glad that you have chosen to be with us this morning. Whether you're just having a look or seeking a place to worship, we are delighted to have you here. And though we may not be able to meet together physically, that is not going to stop us from rallying together spiritually. Join us online for a time of worship and a message from Pastor Marlon Curtin. Join us in experiencing the joy of singing to the Lord with the gospel duo, Melody and Harmony.
Forward, I'm gonna leap, I'm forging.
Bible Study is coming back with the topic Pressure, Pain, and Persecution, the Suffering of Christ. Tune in on Tuesday, September 12th on Zoom, meeting ID 960-2462-6792 and password 271927.
Let's pray. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for your goodness. We thank you, Lord, for your mercy. We pray, Lord, that your hand is upon this ministry today. Keep us safe. Keep us safe today. Make sure that everything that's supposed to happen will happen. Come against disorder. Come against chaos. Come against any kind of distraction. Pray that your will be done today and that your people be blessed. That your will be done today and your people be blessed. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Today's scripture of the day is taken from Revelation chapter 22, verses 6 and 7, in the Christian Standard Bible Version. Then he said to me, "These words are faithful and true. The Lord, the God of the spirits of the prophets, has sent his angel to show his servants what must soon take place. Look, I am coming soon. Blessed is the one who keeps the words of the prophecy of this book." The Rockaway Cathedral is a nonprofit organization that is seeking to win souls for the Lord in the Far Rockaway community. We especially want to make a difference in the lives of those who are often disenfranchised. However, we need your support to get there. Your act of kindness can be a lifesaver for someone. Remember, richness is not necessary, but willingness is. Please visit our website at www.therockawaycathedral.com. Click on the blue Donate tab at the bottom of the page, then click Make a Donation. We are also asking that you continue to support us by viewing our service once a week. We're now on Cash App. You can send your donations to hashtag Rockaway Cathedral. We thank you for your partnership and continued support.
Good morning, good morning. God bless you. Welcome to the Rockaway Cathedral. My name is Pastor Maul. We are here in Carlton Manor. We're here at Carlton Manor. Today is our back to school event. Today's message will be called Solid Gold. Today's message will be called Solid Gold. It's part of our apocalypse series. Now, I remember summer's almost over. To you parents, summer's almost over. Take the time to enjoy these last couple of weeks with your kids. Some of you have already sent your kids back to school, but take the time that you have, that you need, to enjoy life with your children. Life is short, goes like this. Turn around, next thing you know, they're 21. Next thing you know, they're 40. So enjoy the time that you have with your children. This message is called Solid Gold, part of this series called Apocalypse. Today's message is called Solid Gold. Be blessed.
Join us as we welcome the gospel duo Melody and Harmony.
No one knows the day, nor the
good morning. God bless you. Welcome to the Rockaway Cathedral. Today's message is called Solid Gold. Today's message is called Solid Gold, part of our Apocalypse series. Scripture can be found in Revelation 21, verses 15 and 21. Revelations 21, verses 15 and 21. I'm going to be reading from the Christian Standard Bible. Please stand for the reading of God's Holy Word. It's Revelation 21, verses 15 to 21. Here beginning the reading of God's Holy Word. The one who spoke with me had a golden measuring rod to measure the city's gates and its wall. The city's laid out in a square. Its length and width are the same. He measured the city with the rod at 12,000 stadia. Its length, width, and height are equal. Then he measured its wall, 144 cubits, according to the human measurement, which the angel used. The building material of its wall was jasper, and the city was of pure gold, as clear as glass. The foundation of the city wall were adorned with every kind of jewel. The first foundation is jasper. The second, sapphire. The third, chalcedon. The fourth, emerald. The fifth, sardonyx. The sixth, carnelian. The seventh, crystallite. The eighth, beryl. And the ninth, topaz. The tenth, chrysoprase. The 11th, jacinth. The 12th, amethyst. The 12 gates were 12 pearls. Each individual gate was made of a single pearl. The main street of the city was pure gold, as transparent as glass. Lord, speak to your servant today. Bless your people. In Jesus' name, amen. So the President of the United States is Joe Biden. The President of the United States is Joe Biden. And the President, all Presidents, they get an opportunity to live in the White House. They get an opportunity to live in the White House, which is in Washington, D.C. They also have an opportunity, when they fly on Air Force One. They fly on Air Force One. And when they drive, of course, they are driven in a black limousine. President of the United States, the most important, most powerful person in the world. And to show what we think, to show what this country thinks of our leader, our president, our commander-in-chief, lives in a house, right? The White House, flies in a plane, Boeing 747, and he drives, is driven in a limousine, because that's what countries do for their leaders. Don't worry, that's just a balloon. Let's read the scripture again. I'm not going to read the whole thing. I'm going to read just verse 21. 12 gates of 12 pearls. Each individual gate was made of a single pearl. The main street of the city was pure gold, transparent as glass. I have 3 points today. Point one is the president. The President of the United States is Joe Biden, but, you know, we've had other presidents. This is the 45th president we've had. The technology changes over time, but, you know, all countries have some sort of leader, some president, some prime minister, some king, some queen. All countries have some kind of leader. All countries have a leader, whether it be president, whether it be prime minister, whether it be chief, whether it be king, whether it be queen. They all have leaders. And all of these places, they make sure, right? They make sure that the president, the prime minister, the king, the queen is well taken care of. They want to make sure that this person represents the best that this country has to offer. So we have a White House with it's on 18 acres of land. It's over 130 rooms in the White House. The plane that the president flies in is the 747, which is one of the largest planes in the world. It could accommodate, I believe, up to 70 people, right? And it has all sorts of technology and all sorts of features to make sure that it's a working place. The president can work in Air Force One. The president can lounge in Air Force One. The president could give press conferences in Air Force One, and the president could entertain in Air Force One. If something needs to be done militarily, the president can act while on Air Force One. And in the limousine, it has all kinds of features to protect the president. But what it does, living in a White House, a place with 18 acres and over 130 rooms, having this large, impressive blue and white painted plane, to have this large Cadillac limousine, what it does is it projects America. When the president goes to a foreign country, when the president goes to different parts of this country, this person, right, projects the image and the power and the prestige of the United States of America. And so it should be. We are, in many respects, the most powerful country in the world. In many respects, the most influential country in the world, definitely the richest country in the world, and one of the most powerful, not the most powerful, military in the world. So the president that represents us, the president that represents we the people, the president doesn't own it. He doesn't own the White House. We own the White House. He doesn't own Air Force One. It's a military jet. He doesn't own the limousine. We own the limousine. But it doesn't matter who owns it or doesn't, but what it is, when whoever is president, when they represent us on the world stage or in any part of this country, we want to make sure that they project the prestige, the image, the power of this country. And that's how it is for all countries that have leaders. Their leader, their president reflects the power, the glory, and represents the interests of the country, whether they're in country or abroad. Point two, City of God. City of God is represented in Revelation this way. It's a 12,000 stadium, which is about 1,400 to 1,500 miles. So the city of God, which represents God, the city of God, which represents the power of God, the city of God, which represents the prestige of God, it's called the New Jerusalem, coming down from heaven. New Jerusalem, coming down from heaven. 12 gates named after the 12 tribes of Israel. 12 foundations named after the 12 apostles of the Lamb. Right, the city is of pure gold. The gates surrounding the city is of jasper. Jasper could be, depends. It could be red. It could be green. So you got a gold city, surrounded by possibly a green wall, and 12 gates. 3 gates on one side, another side, another. So the gates are pure white. Pure. This is the elegance that the Lord has. 1,500 miles wide, 1,500 miles long, 1,500 miles high. It's a number that's too hard to calculate. Think about how much gold costs per ounce, hundreds of dollars per ounce, and now you have a city of pure gold. Streets are paved with gold because what the city of God represents, what the New Jerusalem represents, it represents the power and the prestige of Almighty God. If we have a White House that represents the prestige and the power of the United States, if we have an Air Force One that represents the power and prestige of the president, if we have a limousine with all these features that represents the power and the prestige of the president, this city represents the power and the prestige of our God, the maker of heaven, the maker of earth, the one who started it all, the one who created everything in this universe, the one who created mankind. The city of God, the New Jerusalem, represents the power and the prestige of Almighty God. Point 3, you. But one of the things that it says about this city, says that unlike the White House, I mean, you could go visit the White House. There's certain ways to do it. There's a whole process for that. But pretty much any American could make an appointment under the right circumstances. I don't know what the rules are. You can look up what the rules are, and if you follow the rules under the right circumstances, you get a chance to tour the White House. And if you're fortunate, maybe the president will invite you on the Air Force One. And if you're really, really fortunate, because the limousine only seats 7, he'll invite you in the limousine. But most people aren't going to get a tour of the White House. Most people aren't going to fly on Air Force One. Most people are not going to get to ride in the limousine. But what the Word says, what the Bible says, what the Scripture says, is that the place of God will be with men. God will be inhabiting in the city of God. In that city, the Lord Himself will be there. So it's not like there's some kind of division or disconnect between the leader, the ruler, and his people. The ruler and the people will inhabit one place. Now, obviously, there's more to heaven than this, because we don't know exactly what heaven's going to be. This is just a very detailed description of one city as part of heaven, part of the new earth. So there's going to be a new heaven, new earth. Don't know what the new earth is going to look like. Don't know what the new heaven's going to look like. Nobody knows. But we do know what the new city of God, the new Jerusalem, looks like. And what it says, it's unlike the president, unlike your prime minister, unlike your king, unlike your queen, unlike your president, your prime minister, your king, your queen, your ruler. This ruler will be, his place will be among the people. We'll walk around and see God, see his face, and have an opportunity to interact and communicate with God. That's the kind of God that we have. Not only has majesty beyond anything anybody has ever seen, has power and authority, but also is willing to live with, hang out, socialize with the people, right? Who are in the new Jerusalem, who are in the new city of God. But there's a catch. It says those whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Those are the ones that are going to be in the city. You whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. That's going to be the new citizenry. Those are going to be the new people. And they says people from all nations, right, all tribes. You know, not going to be just this kind of people, that kind of people. All nations. There are going to be people represented from all nations and all communities, all eras of time, long time ago or last week. So. But the key, the criteria, is having your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life. So the question is, you know, people talk about the apocalypse,
the end times, the last days. And there are many things that are very, very difficult to deal with and talk about when it comes to the apocalypse. So we're going to talk about those things at some point in the future. But so far, we've talked about, I guess, the good parts. And this is the crowning achievement of the apocalypse. At the end of all time, the judgment's over. Antichrist is out of the way. The devil is defeated. And the judgment is behind us. And now God's people, the people of God, whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life, now they get an opportunity. Now they get a chance. Now they get an opportunity. Now they get a chance to live the rest of their days in the presence of God and with the community of each other. Is your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life? Well, the way to do it, if you confess Jesus Christ as Lord and believe in He's raised from the dead in your heart, thou shalt be saved. But with the heart, man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. And when that happens, your name will be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. So, that's it. You're here today. If you've never accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of your life, if you've never accepted Him as Lord and Savior of your life, if that's you, pray this prayer after me. Lord, I'm a sinner. Please forgive me my sins. I know You came for me. I know You lived for me. I know You died for me. I know on the third day You rose again from the dead. Today I confess that You are Lord. I believe in my heart that You rose from the dead. Therefore, today, I'm saved. My name is Pastor Marlon. This is the Rockwell Cathedral. Building God's kingdom in you. Go in victory. Go in peace. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thanks for worshiping with us today. We pray that you are blessed by the word brought to us today by Pastor Marlon Curtin. Go in God's grace until we meet again for Sunday service and Tuesdays for Bible study from 7:30 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. Be sure to check out our website for more information about our ministry. God bless you. And remember, you're dismissed from this service, but never dismissed from God's presence.